Attention, big mean hostile alien vessel hovering overhead in an obvious attack posture. This is Spotty Captain Thwistle. I know you are going to torture me, so let's just get this over with right now. The coordinates of my homeworld, Spotiwa, are 241.6 by 368.7, and the ultra-secret Spotty Cipher, which is known only by me and several billion other Spotty, is Hoppy Moppy Duffy. Sorry about that little mistake with your landing vehicle. I was so startled when it approached my vessel in a threatening manner that my automated defense systems fired on it when it got too close. I hope nobody got hurt. Are you sure? Because your statement is often just a more polite way of saying, "Attention alien vessel, identify yourself or be destroyed." In any event, I am Spotty Captain Thwistle of the void ship Star Runner, based here in this planetary system as part of the powerful Earth-scoured Star Force, which our masters, the Earth One, established here to make sure the Earthlings don't do anything tricky. About 20 years ago, this region of space was dominated by a loose confederation known as the Alliance of Free Stars, which was composed of the aliens native to these parts who did not want to be enslaved. They made a valiant effort against the superior Urquan forces. It even looked like they might miraculously defeat the combined armada, right up to the point at which the Urquan totally defeated, indeed annihilated them. When the Urquan Armada entered the system to subjugate formerly the Earthlings, the Urquan presented the humans with the standard slave options. Join the hierarchy as combat roles and recruiting the right to travel through space, or become a fellow species and return to free atomic savagery on the surface of their homeworld, encased for all time beneath an impenetrable force shield. The humans chose the latter option, and so were swiftly imprisoned on the surface of Earth. But the Urquan didn't trust them to obey the restrictions, so they chose a small group of hierarchy combat starships from the Inlet and Spartan fleets to create the so-called Earth Guard, and station them at a base on Earth's moon. Originally, we were stationed on Earth's moon, which made us Spotty a bit uneasy, because with each passing day we grew more and more worried about the sneaky Earthlings making a surprise attack, though the Inlet kept telling us that it was impossible since the Earthlings had no ships or weapons whatsoever. That made us feel a bit better, but when the Inlet left again, we grew fearful and decided to make a strategic redeployment to Mars. Later on, we decided it would be prudent to relocate to Jupiter's moon, Ganymede, then later Saturn's moon, Titan, and finally here to Pluto. The Ilrath contingent were supposed to be the toughest ridge crest, the most rigid flipper, the backbone of the Earth Guard force. But they departed the system en masse not long after the last Earthbound dreadnought vanished from this region of space. They claimed to have received a direct order from their gods of evil and darkness, who had grown dissatisfied with the Inrat's passivity and wanted them to kill or at least torture someone soon. Personally, I believe they just got bored and went off to have some fun. Well, when they were pushing up into hyperspace 18 years ago, we asked them that very question, and I think they said something to the effect of, "Real soon." Redesign decided that if the Earthlings figured out we had abandoned the base on Luna, they would be more likely to try something sneaky. So, we rigged up some old service androids and ordered them to drive around on the lunar surface in bulldozers, endlessly pushing around the same piles of dirt. In addition, we connected the base's local radio transmitter to an audio Melnorme fun rum called Winky's Happy Night, hoping they would think we were still there. Over the past years, it became necessary to redeploy strategically some of our Earth-guard forces to our homeworld in case of a sudden surprise attack by a vicious, unrelenting alien race which we spotted call the Ultimate Evil! Dozens, that is to say, scores, and perhaps even hundreds of my brethren stride through the corridors of this specially modified, super-efficient, mass-destruction-oriented starship, which could lay siege to an entire planetary system should we choose to do so, which, fortunately for you, we have decided not to do today. I am undone! You are far too clever for a poor stuffy like me, and now I must submit to your superior alien intellect. I guess I am not revealing any truly important secrets if I tell you that each of my species' Eluder-class void ships typically holds 30 stuffy crewmen, though at present my vessel, the Star Runner, is fully complement due to the needs of my homeworld in their resistance against the Ultimate Evil! And in fact, my vessel is somewhat understaffed right now, seeing as how I am the only spotter on board, which is a bit threatening. I feel at ease, and yet now I find myself enjoying your company. This witty dialogue, and the presence of your huge, powerful, death-dealing starship, which, being my friend, you would certainly feel compelled to use in order to save me from any hostile lifeforms who threatened me with death. Happy days and jubilation! I discard all prejudice and hesitation and accept and celebrate your offer of protection and your undying commitment to my well-being. I must wax melancholy for just a moment though, and make sure you understand that any other spotty ships we meet at large in the galaxy are not going to be quite so responsive to your friendly gestures as myself, since they bear more heavily the yoke of Urquan enslavement and are also apt to talk themselves out of a line with a totally unknown alien, which I, having been left here alone, cannot do. Welcome me aboard, Captain.
We come in peace. Mission description follows. Traverse space reporting data. Seek materials for replication. Replicate to expand scope of mission. Contact life forms in peaceful manner. After 10 replications, return to point of origin. End of mission description. Priority override. new behavior dictated. Must break target into component materials.
What?